everybody, this is Garrett. Today I'm going to take that bearing retainer out, but in the process I need to make a tool. So I was talking to my older brother and he didn't have a tool, but he did have this piece of metal, which if it looks familiar, you've all seen it. It goes on a garage door opener, and he had it sitting around because it's a good piece of steel. So figured, hey, what the heck, I can drill holes if those holes don't line up, and I can go ahead and then decided that I would use bolts, bolt it through it, leave that sticking out, and then that would be my pin. So this one I ground down just the tip there so I could get it in, no funny intended right there. This will be my pin. Well, both of these will be my pins. And this is the rod I'm going to use. This one, these holes don't quite line up, so I'm going to have to make them bigger. So I decided I'd go with this hole. So I'm not going to drill the hole the exact same size as the pin because I don't need it to be. And I want to have a little leeway just like I do with these. So I am going to drill it just a tad bigger, but I'm going to make a tool. So I'm going to use the drill press. If not, I would have just used my drill to drill a hole through it. All right, so this is the setup. I just got it on. I'm using a 3/8 drill bit because that's what works for me. Clamped it down and already tested it. It's hitting where I want. Okay, there, it's done. So I don't have any like official cutting oil or anything, so I just used some 3-in-1. Dabbed on there a little bit because I'm sure my drill bits suck. But anyway, it is done. Okay, so I got everything cleaned up. I got the hole drilled, I got the bolts through, and this is the end. And that is as far as they go down in there. I did clean the holes out because there's a bunch of gunk in them, but that's it. And so that's what I'm gonna use. First thing I'm gonna do though, before I go any further, now that I have a tool made, I can now get it out, is destaking these. So I'll take a drill to those and then try to do my best to get that out before I start. I drilled out the stakes and then I put my wrench on it and I turned it just a little bit. It did turn, it did come loose. And it was smooth, but we're gonna see how it goes going forward. The noise in the background is my cooler, my evap cooler. If I shut it off for the video, it'd get really freaking hot. It's supposed to be 108 outside today, so I'm in my garage. So sorry for the noise, but I don't feel like sweating to death. At least keep out. So that's what the noise from the cooler is. Seems to be going pretty smooth. Looks pretty gross in there, not too bad, but I think this is the original because it doesn't look like it's been staked twice. So now it's a matter of trying to get that out, but that's the next step. Okay, so there's the bearing. And obviously this is what I showed you before from the other side. So I need to get the bearing out. So I'm just gonna do some jerry-rigging here and try and figure something out, because I don't own every tool under the sun. So I'm going to attempt to use this with some super thick washers and maybe this if I can. But this is my whole thought process. So I'm filming this for those guys who don't have every tool and they're just trying to think of stuff. Okay, so I was having zero luck with that, and I tried all sorts of configurations, couldn't get it to work, and I was afraid that I would end up chipping or breaking something on that, and I didn't want that. So I just took it out and I decided, what the heck, I'm going to heat it up. So I set the hub up on there and I heated it. If I can get this to focus, I heated this area all the way around for about, I don't know, 4 minutes. So I just heated it up, picked it up with my bare hands, or maybe I might have used some gloves. And I put it right here because it was really freaking hot. I then put my two washers that were just the right size in there. I took a broken extension that I have as a punch. I sent it right over the hole. Then I took my sledgehammer to it and I nailed it once, and then the whole thing dropped right on out. And there, it just dropped out the bottom. So I guess if you don't have a puller or something, whatever, I guess that's an easy way. It worked for me, heated it up. And what reminded me of it was getting the alternator cover bearing out, which was heat up the outside and it just dropped out. So I thought I'd try it with this, and it worked. So I'll work on getting the rest of that out in a minute, as soon as it cools down. There it is, there's the bearing. I don't see any damage done on the inside. It all looks pretty good.